down, Marty.
And, okay, we're live. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Facebook. I am Marty KC1CWF, and this is the Phasing Radio Ham Line, whatever it is. Pick a name. This is Gary's show with me hijacking and a bunch of nutcases on the side on the TV screen up there. But we'll get to that in a second. You know, when we sat down to press the live button, we never really decided what we're going to talk about. But this is dating stuff.
It's the free dating show.
Gary wanted the free dating show, but so we have 2 4-year-olds and a 2-year-old in the center. That's Gary. I'm Marty KC1CWF. Let's see. Do we want to go around the horn, David? Give your call sign.
I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG.
It grows out of the top of his head. You can kind of see it.
Yeah,
I guess I'm.
Yeah.
What's your name?
I am Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, the host of Ham Radio Now, and the person who would be running the show except for major technological failures.
So thank you, Microsoft.
On my notebook.
And he is up there. What's your name? Neil. Nope. What's his name?
And I'm Neil Rapp, WB9VPG from HamTalkLive. And if this is the dating show, then I guess it's just single white male 46.
Free dating show.
Free dating show.
We're saying that because when I tried to put an announcement up of this on the Facebook page, I did it on my phone with voice recognition, and it came up with free dating show. I said pre-dating show, and it interpreted that as free dating show. So the phone knows what's going on. That must be it.
So I suggested to Gary that we need to create a new show that's a ham dating show. It could be the dating game, but with ham radio.
Yeah.
I'll be there for that.
The only one available to be dated is my wife, Cindy, and Katie Allen, and they're both married, so
stop being a joke.
Well, Marty could we'll offer Marty up.
And of course, I've already screwed up the live stream. What do you expect? Okay, and we're back. Cool. We never lost it. Just
no. Running. It's still there. It's still running, Marty.
Yeah. Does it I'm look watching okay? It. Does the video look okay?
You have to stop switching so often. No, that's actually buttons. The four shot is actually pretty good.
Cool. And I agreed to this. Why?
Clearly, you've got no life.
Yes.
Monday
He's a
night.
Teacher, what do you
anything.
Expect?
I fell for the, hey, can you record something for a second for me?
let me just quote what I said. I Facebook messengered him, and I said, let's see exactly what I said. I said, you free to record something? And he said, crap, I just packed up all the audio gear. And I go, well, okay, no worries, do it on your phone. Phone mic? Okay, yeah. Just got home, packed everything up, I'll Skype you. And he's a brave soul, let me tell you, that little guy.
See, the audio gear is packed.
In the very technical plastic case.
Yes.
Yep.
Very.
And so we're going to Dayton. Well, that let's point. That loser isn't
going,
the rest of us
we're
are.
Going to Dayton.
Yeah.
Some of you are going to Dayton.
And some uncool person is not going to Dayton. We're
most of you are
left.
Going to Dayton.
David.
It's all me. Yeah, I'm sorry. Maybe next year.
Get the podcast to pay for it.
I got a project I got to roll out this week.
What? More of this if we go broke stuff?
Yeah.
Unrelated, but I got to ask. Have you been following this Fyre Festival thing at all?
The what?
I'm talking to David.
The what? The
FYRE, the music festival in the Caribbean that never happened, that sort of happened but failed.
You know, I heard something about it, but not following.
Isn't that old news?
Yes, that was last week's fake news.
No, but now there's like $100 million lawsuits and there's a...
That's so 2 days ago.
That's so 2 days ago.
What I know about that, it was a bunch of rich kids who got duped into going to a concert in the Caribbean and there was no concert. And so they just sat on the beach.
Exactly. And this is
and
the Facebook
things could
podcast.
Be worse.
And ate ham and cheese sandwiches.
Woohoo!
It's a terrible life. Okay.
Yeah.
back to that shot.
And as Jeff would say if he were here, and what has that got to do with ham radio?
You know what? Yes. This is my show now. I talk about what I want to talk about.
Hijacked.
And you know what? I have the button to mute all your microphones, too. That's
so wait a minute. Part. You guys are all going to Dayton?
That's a bad segue.
We're going to Dayton, and you're
trying to get the train back on the rails, sir.
Remember, he's the adult.
Okay, let me do I should probably do an intro so I can make a show out of this.
Yeah, go ahead.
Three, two. This is the Phasing Live Podcast, episode number, call it 11. This is This is the Phasing Live Podcast, episode 11 for May 15th, 2017. We're going to Dayton, and we're dating in the process. This is going to be a great show. We have a great group of troublemakers in the house. I'm Marty KC1CWF, David W0DHG. Got that right? Yeah?
You got it right.
Gary Pierce, KN4 Alpha Quebec. And
hello, Phasing Line Podcast. Yeah. See, when you do an audio show, you got to let the people talk so people know what the voices are going to sound like.
You know what? This is my show. and then there's the quiet troublemaker.
You've taken over my show more than once. This is payback.
Okay. And he's Neil Rapp. Say hi, Neil.
Hi, Neil.
Okay.
Awesome.
WB9VPG. And he needs to learn how to use commas, apparently. So we're talking about...
Excuse me. I am all for the Oxford comma. Thank you.
I ate grandma.
Has anybody noticed in all of the stuff that I've done for the past decade or so that I am trying to take the comma out from between a ham's name, comma, and his call sign?
Marty Soloway, comma, KC1CWF.
Yes, I never do that unless I'm writing for QST. And then sometimes I don't, but they put them back in.
Yeah, you can do that if you
want. There's no reason to put a comma between a name and a call sign. No reason at all. And it makes a possessive really hard to figure out.
So how does this have, what does this have to do with Dayton?
You brought up commas. I'm sorry. Your show, you brought
staying
it
at home.
It's a throwdown.
David's staying at home. I put mine in parentheses.
Yeah.
Gary is driving, right? When do you leave?
Early Wednesday morning or late Wednesday afternoon.
Neil is taking his airboat.
Yes, I'm taking my airboat.
Wednesday.
Airboat. Will you video that, Neil, please?
After I take my fish for a walk across the street.
Hey, so Gary, are you going to do a driving episode?
Probably not on the way out, but I might do one on the way back.
And I am taking a flying car. We call it an airplane. And it should be an adventure.
I, however, will be doing some of the driving.
Online. That's the part I most worry about, Gary. Right there. That's the stuff of wonders.
Any weather forecast more than 48 hours in advance is not worth the electrons that display it.
So why do they do it?
Because they can.
They can.
It's just like medicine. They're all practicing.
Why are you?
Get
but he's a chemistry teacher. That's the thing. So let's see. We're going to go to.
Weather is just chemistry, right? Chemistry in the air.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So let's. I'm going to.
I think there's some physics involved, too.
There we go. So I just cut you all off and stuck weather over you. And let me move me out of the way. There we go. Look at that. And Marty's weather show. So if we scroll to the important days of AccuWeather, the highly inaccurate AccuWeather.com, let's see what we got. Okay.
Of course he uses AccuWeather. He's in Boston.
So we're going to have rain every day, basically, is what that weather says. What weather do you like, Neil?
Oh, I like it. It's just, it's always on WBZ, so.
WBZ AccuWeather forecast at 5 minutes past the hour.
Exactly.
So is it rain and thunderstorms?
Yeah.
You guys are all bringing your grounding straps, right?
Yeah, right.
Because you're going to be standing in a concrete parking lot with a big plastic tent over you.
We actually have some photos of these tents now. Somebody posted them in the Facebook group. Let me cut away there for a second. Let me see if I can pull them up. I had received some intel earlier in the week about some photos, but I was sworn to secrecy. And I think now those photos are in the public domain, or somebody else has published photos in the public domain. So I feel comfortable.
Marty, yeah, I hate to break this to you, but I need to QSY in about 8 minutes.
That's okay.
Okay.
That way we can get rid of you.
Marty's shortest short ever.
We should take advantage of him because he's been doing these shows for weeks now, figuring out everything that's coming up. My phone shut up.
Wait, let me just show the picture and then he can talk. Okay?
That's a fancy
show. So the tents were that you guys can't see that I can see.
I can see it.
Okay, you can.
It's all four of us in the chat room.
It's basically a big wedding tent, and windows on the sides. And it'll be interesting to see how they actually do as far as repelling water. But we'll certainly have a chance to explore that. So
I think tent will probably repel water fine. It's a question of whether water will get in underneath it.
It's going to be a side underneath flooding sort of thing. Now, Neil, you don't have a tent, correct?
I do not. Well, actually, I have a tent, but I'm not taking it.
Are you boothing, Neil, or are you just booth? Are you boothing, or are you just?
I'm everywhere.
Can we talk about what Newsline's doing?
I'm doing forums. I'm doing the Superstation, and I'm doing the Amateur Radio Newsline booth.
Talk about the Superstation.
So Emmett's got a bunch of stuff going on with the Superstation. It's big fancy radios, top of the line stuff with maybe slightly more than legal limit amplifiers and all the latest, greatest, big time stuff. And it's your chance to actually try it out.
So here's my gripe. Are they using the same antennas they used last year? Because last year Emmett was using like hex beams at 20 feet, and they did not work for crap.
Yeah, I can't remember. We ran out of time and didn't talk about the details, but I'm supposed to try to help him with that when I'm not at the Newsline booth, when I'm not at one of Carol Perry's forums.
And then what's going on with Newsline?
So, Newsline, we're just getting a booth together to kind of meet and greet and start getting a presence back at Dayton again. So, a bunch of us are getting together, so we're actually going to meet each other in person for the first time, which may be kind of scary. Some of us have met, you know, but a lot of us haven't, so...
What is the Newsline? What are you guys doing for a booth?
So we are actually going to be in with the Ham Nation booth.
Mm-hmm.
They gave us some space.
Not anymore. Not that you showed up here.
Yeah. Now that I'm here.
No, he's on Marty. He's on Marty's show, not our show.
It's not Gary's show. It's Marty's show.
That's right.
Yeah, it's Marty's show. So, yeah, so that's how that all turned out. So, we'll be rolling with that. And as far as Ham Talk Live goes, we're doing a live show from the hotel Thursday night. And we're going to take calls on your favorite hamvention story and all that kind of thing. I'm going to do some live video on the drive over and throughout Hamvention as I can get a signal, and put up some signs and give out some stickers, and Hammy the mascot, Hammy the pig, is going to be dancing around, walking around, taking pictures and stuff, and we're going to have a little contest where you tweet your picture with Hammy the mascot.
Don't call him Marvin.
Tweet that. with hashtag HamTalkLive, and you'll be entered for a chance to win Radio Waves Dipole.
I just got to give a plug for Mr. Rapp here. This guy gave me these two things. I'm holding up to all of you guys on audio who can't hear me. A chicken and some fries. And the fries go squeak, squeak. And the chicken just kind of sits there, but...
And you just scared Allie the cat.
You know what? Okay, I'm sorry, kitty. We got the chicken and the fries, and Marty, KC won chicken with fries. I will be in Dayton with my whole fake plastic animal entourage. So if you want to say hi to the chicken, you want to squeak the fries, you'll be able to. And Gary will not be
carrying the pig. Oh, yeah, is Arvin going?
Arvin will be there, yes.
Did you find a stunt Arvin that's not breakable, or are you taking him?
Hush, just Arvin.
Just Arvin. Awesome.
Have we gotten any comments on the live video?
Yes. Mike Martz, November 8, X-Ray Mike is in the room. He said hi.
Hello, Mike Martz is the absolute number one Ham Radio Now fan.
Really?
Even though you're on phasing line.
What?
Mike Martz is the number one Ham Radio Now fan.
Okay.
Mark Cartwright is like close number two. And I better stop naming people because I'll be leaving people out.
Yeah, you're leaving me out.
Yeah.
You're not a fan, you're a host.
And I'm okay. Just a troublemaker.
Yes, you are.
Yeah. All right. Well, you can come see us at our booth far out in the middle of the ocean of a parking lot. We're booth 6,000 and numbers. 6,000.
664-19.
664-19?
So you guys are sharing a booth, Marty?
Yeah. It's his booth, and I'm going to have booth babes out in front of it, and there'll be a lot of nice women, and it's going to be lovely.
Azimuth Weatherstar is back in business again?
So is there anything that you've been learning over the past many shows that... would be really important for us to know, Neil.
Neil, what is your perception what is your perception as to the readiness of Dara and the venue and their confidence level and your opinion on how well it'll succeed?
It's still hard to judge that. And I'm not going to make any decisions until I see it. I think it could go a billion different ways, but I think what I've learned most is what they started really publicizing more in the last few days, which is there is a traffic pattern, there are directions, there are remote parking options, there are talk-in options, and you need to look that stuff over before you go.
So it's a two-lane road that they're claiming to bring 35,000 people into.
Yeah.
I claim that because my perception of their ticket sales is that they are counting the people, the attendance based on ticket sales, which is a terrible statistic due to the fact that many people have more than one ticket. I, for example, have 5 tickets. So I find it utterly hard to believe that there will be 35,000 people. But they claim there will be, so we can buy in for now.
We'll see.
I find it'll be interesting.
It sounded optimistic to me.
Why'd you buy 5 tickets, Marty?
I didn't buy any of them. I have a meeting.
All right, Marty. Marty, how long are you going here?
5 more minutes.
Oh, okay. I got to run. I was going to say maybe I could pop back in, but...
Do you have 3 minutes?
No, I gotta run. I gotta see if Newsline automatically fires on the repeater.
All right. Bye-bye.
All right.
See you, Neil. Have a great Dayton.
Thanks.
Ciao.
Gary, Marty, see you. See you in a few days.
See you there.
So now we really don't have any adult supervision with knowledge. Gary and I are children. David is the adult, but David's not going. He's already been there.
Sadly.
You've never been there, right?
Point and laugh.
No.
Do people in California? I mean, do they talk about Dayton the way everybody east of the Mississippi does?
Or is, you know, I have a couple. I have a couple of friends. One of my good friends, he's a dad in the Boy Scout troop. Steve Nimchek, he's WD8CIK. He has been to Dayton for a number of years, and he's always asking me, you gonna come? I'm pretty sure he's going this year. He's in the industry. He does, he's like the big microwave guy in the Southern California area. I mean, he's a ham. A couple of the other guys I know, they talk about going, but, you know, not a ton of them.
Talking about it,
I mean, not,
extent
not
of their...
Yeah.
Not that many people from right around me in about a 9-hour drive actually go.
In my circles, hear about a lot
it.
Of
Everyone
people
talks go. About it.
In my circles, a lot of people go. All my content, you know, as much as the vendors and the events are kind of an important thing, for the contesting circles, the big exciting part is the social suites, the hospitality suites at the Crown Plaza Hotel, and the nightly dinners to celebrate different aspects of contesting. And that's the most exciting part for me.
So is that what you're going for primarily? So I'd want to go see all the new stuff.
There's not as much new stuff as you'd think.
Yeah.
You know, a radio here, a radio there.
Right. There'll be some new radios.
There'll probably Hopefully be new radios.
Icon will have new radio and get to see the new Yaesu handheld. Do some other stuff.
Yep.
Where are you going for, Gary?
And once in a while there's a real surprise, and they like Kenwood's D-Star handheld last year was a big surprise.
Kenwood is due to release a mobile radio, I think. I would speculate.
A D-Star mobile radio? Yeah.
And a HF radio. Because the last time they put out a mobile HF radio was the TS-480. That was a while ago.
And that was not really a mobile radio. It was mobileable, but...
It has a mobile head.
It was pretty big.
Detachable head, but... well, it's not really a detachable head because the head doesn't attach to begin with. But... There's that. And they really haven't released an HF radio in a couple of years, so I don't know.
Maybe Elecraft will surprise us with a fully software direct sampling radio.
Marty doubts this.
Yeah, I heard them on some other podcast. I think they have some amplifier coming or something like that.
There's the KPA 1500, which was announced at the Visalia DX convention, will be on display, which is a 1500-watt dual-device linear amplifier with a separate power supply.
So there may not be much from the big manufacturers, you know, or each one of them does something.
I think Icon
may have...
But
there'll be lots of stuff. Lots of stuff from the little guys.
Yeah. And Icon may have a 7610 for people to put their hands on, I believe.
Yeah. So I go mostly for the show. Since the major manufacturers are just doing sales pitches, or if any of us go talk to them, and it's hard to pry them out of sales pitch mode. I like to look at the little guys that that bring their stuff, because those guys are professional salesmen. And where they may do start with a bad sales pitch, they usually end up just talking like a human being.
It's typically a pretty bad sales pitch, too.
If they do sales pitch, it's a bad one.
Yeah. So you're gonna go along and do the 2-camera thing?
4 cameras.
Just walking around will be two. And that will be Friday afternoon. I'll be recording the Tapper Forum Friday morning. And then I'm just trying to line up interviews in the booth on Saturday.
And then maybe we'll roam again on Sunday, right?
It depends.
Yeah.
If I get booth interviews, And feel that I've seen the HamFest and how it all works out. And I would like to have more time to do it all.
Yeah. Gary is going to be doing a lot of video interviews in the booth. I'm going to do some audio interviews. I'll do some with video with Gary, I assume.
Sure.
And then maybe I'll do some by myself if I get sick of him and he gets
it'll be David's surrogate.
You'll need staff, Gary. That's what it is. Next year, are you gonna hit the flea market?
No.
It's gonna rain.
It's gonna rain.
maybe we can walk and talk for an hour. We can stick a camera in Jeff's face.
You could point the camera out the window and laugh. They're out there.
Yeah, Jeff is going to be there. He's going to be doing VE stuff on a good deal of Friday, but we might be able
to. On Saturday, maybe we can go in the flea market with Jeff. I've yet to meet Jeff. I've never actually talked to Jeff, but I think we'll hit it off.
Jeff's not a ham anymore. I'm revoking his license.
What? But he's a
technical. You're going to get the power to do that.
I have the power.
When are we going to have Cindy on an episode of Ham Radio Phasing Line Now?
Cindy's not a ham anymore either. I'm revoking her license too.
You're revoking. Where do you get this power?
So Mike asked in the chat room, any other forums other than Tapper that you're going to do, Mike, Gary?
That's the only one I'm planning on. I would love to be able to do forums all day long, but I can't do both, and I would rather talk to people.
Yeah.
I've invited some of the folks that are doing forums to come over to the booth and talk about what their forum subject is. Because I'd rather, whenever I'm recording a forum, it's like every 45 seconds, I've got a question I want to ask.
And you can't ask the question.
Right.
Well, I suppose I could.
You could. I could see you in the back of the room going, wait a minute, I have a question.
But the thing you can do 20-minute interviews that get across just as much information as an hour-long form. Although knowing Gary, he'll do a two-hour-long interview just to make a point of doing long interviews. Nobody will watch.
And get less information.
Right.
But the forums aren't designed to be dialogues. They're
forums.
Yeah.
Lectures. Right. Symposiums, if you will.
Yeah, it's just a big dump, which is okay.
Well, you know, this has been a great episode of the Phasing Ham Radio Now. I think we should end now.
The free dating show.
The free dating show. I'm Marty.
It was going to be an episode of Ham Radio Now, but my technology failed.
Because is it still doing the whole?
I've got Wirecast back up, but the one monitor's not working. So.
Reboot.
No, I've done reboot. I think it's hardware.
Uh-oh. No okay. bueno.
No bueno.
No bueno. That means when you get back on, when do you get back? Tuesday?
Middle of next week. Yeah,
early. David, is that the extent of your Spanish? No bueno?
No, I got a little more than that, but not a ton.
Hola. Adios.
Yeah.
Yo hablo español muy bien.
What? Don't lay a la baño.
Gary's mouth.
Donde está Casa de Pepe?
Yes, right. La baño.
L.
Casa de Pepe.
Yes, right. So where are you going for, Marty, before you hang up on us?
Where am I going for?
What are you going for? What do you want to see?
I want to see everything. I want to talk to everybody. I want to hear about all the good stuff, and I want to ask the hard questions. You know, I take pleasure in, you know, especially when vendors have kind of had crises or PR issues or they're not being clear. I really enjoy asking the hard questions.
Where did you learn that?
What? Not from you. The hard questions. Not from you.
Who else does it?
There's nobody else that does it.
You know, I actually have a life outside of ham radio podcasts. Despite how it looks.
You clearly do because you're not making any podcasts.
If you'd like to edit mine.
No, I don't want to edit yours. I don't want to edit mine.
I think we need to make a pitch to my co-host to come back.
Yeah, how's Sterling doing?
I haven't really talked to him. He's been busy. His project, which he went in secrecy to do, failed.
Stuff happens.
Hopefully he'll be back soon. He's been pretty busy. He's getting married, you know, moving.
That wasn't the project that failed.
No.
Yeah, hopefully not.
You're such a... We need like a discipline. Where's Cindy? We need to like Cindy, come put your husband in timeout.
So I'm mobile. I can go try to find her.
Yeah,
so, Cindy. Last couple times that I've been on Skype with Gary, Cindy actively tries to avoid being on the show.
Cindy's very nice. I really like
there Cindy. Was the whole there was the whole couch and on, TVs. Yeah.
We're getting depends a tour of Gary's house.
Yeah. Getting a tour of my thumb.
All the ceilings in Gary's house.
It's a lovely white to, unplug the headphones so she can hear, assuming I find her at all.
There's stairs, so it's a multi-level house.
There she is. Can I put you on television, dear?
No.
She says, but I'm going to do it anyway.
I told you.
Say hi, Cindy.
Hi, Cindy.
From the Phasing Live podcast.
Okay.
And Facebook Live. On the Ham Radio Now. This is by popular demand. They wanted to see.
You're on Marty's show. With two cats. That was one.
With the cat.
The cat.
Which one is that?
It's on the blind.
What?
He's a blind kitty.
Huh. Gary, your hands are far loud. The shaking of your hands is very loud. Her voice is not.
I'll try to calm things down. I couldn't hear anything because I had my headphones on and I couldn't hear the speaker.
Okay, now say something, Cindy.
So this is Sarah.
Yeah, there we go. I'm not sure if you can see me. I'm Marty Soloway. There we go. Why don't I have a camera? Let's see. Exit full screen. Tools. Options. Video settings. There we go. There's the second camera. Full screen. There we go. You can see me now. Look at that.
Half of you.
Half of me.
Half of Marty. Half of Marty's better than no Marty at all.
It's probably worse than no Marty at all. Let me switch.
So what are we talking about other than bugging?
Why you aren't going to Dayton.
Talking about Dayton.
Humiliate her for not going to Dayton.
Yeah, I've tried to call it the pre-Dayton show, but my voice recognition changed that to free dating show, so that's what this is.
Wow, okay. So,
and so we figured out
why am I not going to Dayton?
Where are the girls in ham radios for free dating?
I found you.
Hello.
The one.
Originally, I told them to go find you so you can put him in timeout, because he was being naughty. But
see, if I send him to his room, he has too much fun.
Yeah.
That's true. That's where all the good stuff is.
Yeah. So back to Dayton. You want to know why I'm not coming?
Yeah, back to cats.
Back to cats. Yeah, that looks better.
Well, yeah. Actually, a little bit earlier, I was announcing that I was revoking your ham license and Jeff's ham license.
Okay.
I don't think you're okay.
Doesn't sound like a big loss there. The only thing... It'll mean is you guys can't talk when you're skiing anymore, right?
Yeah.
Actually,
That was your last ham radio, I guess.
Yeah, you're right. You're right, because we switched from the FRS to the other radios. The
DMR.
She knows what those acronyms mean. That's impressive. Most people don't.
Do you know what DMR is?
Digital radio mode.
Mobile.
Okay, close. Radio. Close.
Yeah. FRS?
Family Radio Service.
Okay. M-U-R-S?
M-U-R-S.
Yeah, nobody knows what that is.
Multi-use radio service.
I know what it is. Which one? How about the GMRS? That's the other one. Nobody gets that one either.
It's the General Mobile Radio Service, but I was trying to come up with something funnier.
Grandmother's Radio Service.
Anyway, we're going back to you all riding off into the sunset. You're asking me why I'm not going to Dayton.
Why are you not going to Dayton?
Because I'm busy.
Hey, you're getting rid of him for a couple days.
Well, actually, I was out of town all last week, so we only have, 3 days together, sort of?
Yeah.
Until you head off again.
Out of the 52 weeks a year, we actually get to see each other about four.
That's how it is at my house, too, Gary.
That's exaggerating.
Gary, I think you're being mean to your wife. You should really be nicer.
Exaggerating, kind of like the way Michael Coulter was estimating crowd size of Dayton this year.
Okay. Anyways, okay, that's...
I think we've wrapped up our Cindy interview. Let's cut back to the live studio now, where we have
Thanks Gary for Pierce. Joining us, Cindy.
No problem. You all have fun. I can hear you in the background upstairs, but I'm not following exactly what's going on. I can't hear everything. Well, no, I can't. No, because you got your headphones on.
So Facebook
I
can't Live.
Really hear.
Facebook
you
Live.
You can watch us live on the internet.
I'm working.
She claims to be working. Although this doesn't look like work. She's talking about knee replacements.
Gary, hello. Just go back upstairs.
Thank you, Marty. Thank you.
Good night, Cindy.
I'm going Bye. Mobile.
See you guys. Have fun.
I'm going mobile. This is our kitchen.
You going to do a real estate podcast too?
She does all of her kitchen. Work. She's got an office. She does all of her work sitting in the kitchen.
Well, if somebody's room didn't have so much computers in it blowing off all the hot air, which keeps the upstairs hot, I could work in my office in the summer.
Danger, Will Robinson.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gary, just remember, it's all your fault.
It's always my fault.
That's okay. It's the same reason I ended up shooting this all from the garage, too. I can't be in the office at the same time.
Okay. Well...
So while he's going, give your sales pitch, Marty.
This is the Hammer. This is the Basic Live podcast. Their show has plenty of money. You want to give us money? Go to the basiclivepodcast.com. Click that donate button. Then you can pick how you want to give us money. If you are nice, you can give us money monthly. If you're also nice, you can give us a lot of money once. And we really like your money. We really like your money.
Wait a minute, Gary. Show us that really professional camera you got behind you there.
No, that I've got makes
five of them, which is why I need more money than Marty does.
No.
Is that the one you shoot? Is that the one you shoot for him regularly?
That is the one that shoots the over the shoulder shot that you see the monitor over my shoulder.
See,
where's the one you stare into?
See, but Gary is trying to make money and live off of hams. I am just trying to sustain the show.
I thought you weren't supposed to do. You're not supposed to make money off of ham radio.
Yeah.
Right. I thought Cindy was your retirement plan.
Yeah.
There's the one I stare into.
What did he say?
That's the one he stares into. Yeah. Was that it, all I can see is the monitor.
It's above the monitor.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Switch back.
There it is. Oh boy, fancy.
I like old style TV there, the CRT.
Yeah, I can't get rid of that. No one wants it. I mean,
Does it work?
Oh yeah.
Does it work?
Yeah.
4K. Actually, 8K. Full.
So I got Wirecast working again. Sitting there on that monitor. Well, this monitor.
But the other monitor is still dead.
Yeah, it's reflecting me nicely.
Let's see if we can key you out with the.
If you go do an Alt W, does it show up all the monitors there?
The driver, the display driver, and all that stuff is there.
Uh huh.
Just
not showing you anything.
Not making video makes more. No. I got it unplugged. I'll plug it back in.
Drum roll.
And that works.
Looks like a display port.
Oh, I heard it.
We like the ding.
Windows said that was the happy sound.
Look at that.
Woohoo!
It's back. You fixed it.
For the win.
I'll send you a bill. I'll send you a bill. Yeah, no, my tech support, my billing. He's not under retainer. That's $800 an hour with a 6-hour minimum.
There you go.
So wait
I'm
a minute.
I'm in the wrong business. Wait.
Oh, no.
He's going to make this a Ham Radio Now episode no matter what. Brought to you by
Patreon. Go to patreon.com/raisinglinepodcast to make a non-tax deductible donation. That would make me very happy. Thank you. I have no issue soliciting money. Let me make that very clear.
Excellent. Are you guys raking it in?
No.
30 bucks a month?
30 bucks a month.
That's all right.
I'm doing about 300.
Yeah.
Buy a camera or two.
My expenses are more than 30 bucks a month, though. That's
yeah, of course. This is a labor of love, Marty.
remember, you can't make money off of hams.
Yep.
Some hams think...
No. You can't make money on the radio. But we're not on the radio.
We're on the internet.
Right.
I think ICOM is making plenty of money off of hams.
There you go. Exactly. And Kenwood and Yaesu, they're making a little
Kenwood
bit.
Kenwood and Yaesu are going out of business.
A little to bit. Be honest. Well, you know, they got that new HT. It's because $600. Right. Did you get one, Mark?
No.
But somebody who told me, one of the guys I know said it's like holding a hand grenade. And he said he knows what holding a hand grenade's like back from the days in Vietnam. That's what he told me.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing, holding a hand
grenade? You know, I don't know. But I guess he gives him credibility. Because I don't know from holding hand grenades.
So you claim. You know, bigger to Vegas when you want to get people to speed up, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't do the hand grenade thing. You don't do the hand grenade thing. Is it working, Gary?
Yeah, everything's working. I'm going to call you guys on the Ham Radio Now Skype line.
We're going to do a 4-minute show.
Don't you like this, Gary's? This is Gary's.
Just hug up. That's the Gary. That's like the book jacket cover picture.
That's like Gary. I just got sued and I'm testifying by Skype. No, that's a ridiculous claim. No, I don't spend my life doing.
He's going to call you or me? He's going to call both of us.
He's calling me. I called him. I'm calling him. Oh, you know what? I called the wrong Skype.
You're going to call him? I think he's got to call you.
No, he tried to call me.
Oh, and he hung up?
No, I told him no. This will work.
No bueno. No bueno. There he is. There he is.
Yeah.
You're still on your phone, Gary.
Radio Now line.
I'm calling the Ham Radio Now line right now.
No, you called the Pierce 10 line.
Yep. No, I concur.
I'm calling Ham Radio Now right now if you look at the live shot.
Oh.
Gary Pierce 4. Oh, yeah, it is the Gary Pierce 4KN48Q1.
And I'm calling Ham Radio Now.
Well, I'm not seeing it come in.
Oh, you just
yeah, you know, I have that failed. Occasionally. Because you're on the... Yeah, you got to turn your cell phone off.
But it's two different accounts.
Oh, that's true.
Ham Radio.
This one.
Can we end this now?
Oh, nope. Actually, I got to go to Scouts, but I got 5 minutes.
Okay, Gary, this isn't worth your time. Stop.
I can't even text that one.
Neil Rapp, WB9VPG.
Is Neil back?
Neil's back.
I'm back.
So was it live?
The Rapp is back in town.
Did it work?
Oh, I can't see my video. Am I there?
Your video's not on.
No, you're the happy blue guy. Oh.
Okay,
That's a nice shot of you. The nice background. There he is.
Yeah. All I see is happy
blue guy. No, it did not work. I had to do it by hand. So.
Oh, no.
But
it's a good thing you did drop off then.
Yeah. So I figured you guys would still be here. So I figured I'd.
Were you anchoring? Were you anchoring this week?
No.
Let's see if I can.
I am not.
Ready? Let's do something fun for a minute. Marty is going to find. Wrong window. Okay. Let's see. ARNewsline.org, right?
Yes.
Let's see. ARNewsline.org.
In fact, I didn't even have a story on this week.
Let's see. Let's see how Marty does pretending to be a broadcaster. This should be funny. So let's see. There we go. It's up on the screen. Echo.
Oh, somebody's got their mic open.
Amateur Radio Newsline Report 2063 for Friday, May 12th, 2017. Amateur Radio Newsline Report 2063 with a release date of Friday, May 12th, 2017. To follow in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The following is a QST. The FCC gets a strong dose of malicious interference. AMSAT Sweden reaches a milestone year. And our top story, which looks at the impact of hands-free legislation on hams with mobile rigs. All this and more on Amateur Radio Newsline Report 2063, coming your way. Right now.
You look really good now, Gary.
Are you getting my big show shot here?
It looks nice. So who went to go FCC yourself.org?
I did.
Or .com. I tried. I tried.
Wait,
it.
Where's I got the rest? I lost the rest of you guys.
We lost Neil.
Oh,
I'm here.
Uh oh.
I see Neil.
No.
I tried to get there and said they weren't accepting commentary anymore.
Oh, we broke it.
Yeah.
Well, they got a denial of service that broke it.
So what was this?
Yeah, that was us. It was not a denial of service.
So what was it?
I think that's false.
Somebody went out and got go FCC yourself.
Yeah, that was who was it?
John Oliver.
Yeah. He said, go share your happiness. It was a redirect. He said, go share your happiness with the FCC.
Okay, so Gary, your video is too big now. This won't work.
No, it looks really good. So here's a question, Gary. How do I look coming back now with a big pipe?
I just hung up on him. This video thing. This thing worked with... Oh, there we go.
Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Oh, that's the right one.
Oh, that is the right one. There we go.
Maybe I should have stayed.
Yeah.
Nope. Gary, when you send your video, it screws it all up.
It looks really good, Gary.
I know, but he bumps the rest of you guys off.
We were freezing with Marty's.
See. Oh, the problem is if I send if I do a share screens, because you're probably already doing a share screens.
Right.
Wait, Gary, you're not streaming the video too, are you?
No.
No. Okay.
But
if you share the screen, it's gonna.
Let's
see. Yeah, if you're doing a share screens, only one person on a Skype call can do a share screen.
So something's weird's happening because Gary, I can't get your video anymore, Gary.
Right. The only way I can send you video is
by sharing screen.
Share screen.
And sharing screens won't let you do a split screen where I can stack all of you guys. So just call us back on your phone so we can finish the show up.
But, yeah, we got to finish the show up because I got to get out of here shortly.
I hang up on him.
Did you just like, oh, I'm not going to give you a chance to say I'll call you back. I'm just going to hang up.
Yeah.
And then we'll call you back.
I can do that.
It's teenage phone courtesy.
Neo Rapp, have you graded your homework yet?
I don't have any homework. We've been doing labs, so labs. I don't have any homework.
What labs did you do today?
Well, we're in the middle of qualitative analysis and AP chemistry. And then we did a vinegar analysis. We did the acid and base testing lab.
Oh my God, acids and bases. This is an AP. Yes. This is an AP chem.
No, that's in that was in honors chem.
I was gonna say I don't think that's AP material.
And then in organic chemistry, we did functional groups.
What are functional groups?
They're different things that you can attach to organic molecules.
Cool.
Gary's back on his tablet again.
The best thing is Neil doesn't know the material. He reads it out of a book.
He gets the teacher's answer sheet. That's the only way.
Now, the first thing you do is you throw the book out.
But you don't burn it, though, right? You just throw it out.
Yeah, I thought about that would be a good specific heat experiment.
Didn't you
have calories that will generate? Yeah,
exactly. When did you tell me there was a fire in your room or something? An accidental fire?
No.
He won't say this on live video, you see.
No, what happened, Gary?
I want to go on record to say one thing.
Okay. Uh-oh.
This is worse than a W5KUB hangout.
I am cutting you off. Ready? We're going to hang up on him.
You're welcome.
You can't say that. Not here. Not on the phasing line. You've been cut off. We're going to hang up on you now.
I've got 2 minutes, and I'm going to be a hard stop.
This is the Phasing Line Podcast. I am Marty KC1CWF. What's your name, David?
And I am David Goldenberg, Whiskey Zero Delta Hotel Golf.
He is Neil.
Neil's over there.
Neil Rapp, WB9 VPG.
Neil's over there.
I am Gary Pierce, AN4AQ. See you at Dayton. Over.
No.
And.
Ow.
That's a wrap.
That's a wrap, and may the.
You guys have a. You guys
That's
have
not
a,
how that goes.
You guys have a really great time at Dayton.
No. This is the Phasing Line Podcast. Thank you so much for listening. We really appreciated you tuning into this episode of the Phasing Line. Check us out, phasinglinepodcast.com. go to that download cage, kick the butt, click the buttons, pick the options, give us some money. We appreciate it. The thing's really expensive to do. Subscribe, YouTube, Patreon, PayPal, wherever the pod. What?
You got airplane tickets to buy.
Yeah. Wherever you, whatever podcast you're subscribed to our RSS, just give us some general podcast love. Neo Rapp, hamtalklive.com, listen live Thursday nights, 9 p.m. Eastern. Gary.
We should all hate his Thursday show.
Gary can be found occasionally youtube.com/hamradionow. He posts sporadically. He goes like 10 in a day and then none for a month.
Hamradionow.tv.
YouTube.com/hamradionow as well, right?
That gets you there. You miss all of my epic prose.
And then libsyn.com/hamradionow is also exists.
Yeah, you can get something there too.
David doesn't have a website. He just has a help sign behind his head.
That's right. I have the help sign.
And radios.
Yep. My go box.
In his go box. And I have the chicken and the fries.
Thank you, Marty.
Bye-bye, 73, and we'll see you soon. Next time on W5KUB Amateur Radio Roundtable.
Can you stop recording?
No.
Are we still on Facebook Live?
Let's see what the comments are.
I think
there wasn't a whole lot. We're still on Facebook Live.
Have we not pissed everybody off yet?
There was, you know, at the so who, which of the three of you were in the Facebook Live room watching?
I looked once in a while.
So there
I looked from time to time.
We maxed out at four. That would meant no. I saw
at the max. I saw six.
Oh, okay. So there was me and Mike and some other people, but that was about it. All right, you guys. I'm really jealous. I want to go, and maybe next year.
Bye.
You guys have fun.
Ciao, ciao.
And if you're doing a drive home,
Gary, do you know if there's
home, sir, Gary, call me. I'll be video ready.
If it's possible, yeah.
Gary,
and even if you're there in the show, call me.
Gary, do you know if there's a way to download stream video off of Facebook?
It may be possible for the person who. The admin of the channel or the person who put it up?
Yes.
There's a URL. You can get the URL for the video. If you right-click on the video, Gary, it'll give you the URL. Or Marty.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe possible for anybody.
Yeah, but you can also download it because that's how I did my driving video. I downloaded the Facebook and then put it on YouTube.
All right. Well, bye-bye.
70. It works.
All right, we're out. You guys have fun.
Ciao. I'll see you next time here on... let me hang up and then I'll say goodbye to y'all. Oh, and bye-bye, 73. Everybody on Facebook, we appreciate it. Talk to you soon, 73.
73.
Adios.